window. Our building floated heavily through the cold on shifts of steam that the raging coal-fed furnace forced from the boiler's hull. In showers of spark, the trolleys flashed, careening under our cornice. My mother, my Irish mother, Mary Beamish, who came from Cork, held me up to see the snowfall out the window. Windhold, she sometimes said, as if in Irish it held wind out, or showed us that wind was old. Windhole, in Anglo-Saxon. Anglo-Saxon, faces like brick, they worshipped Easter's rabbit, and mistletoe that was Thor's jism where thunder struck the oak. My Irish mother, my Japanese mother, my Hungarian mother, my Swedish Jewish mother, we took their language in our mouth and chewed. Some of the consonants drove us nearly crazy because we were Chinese. Or was that just the food my father brought from our restaurant downstairs? In the fells, by the falls, the old ghetto, or New Jersey, Little Havana, or Little Russia, I forget, because that baby wasn't me, the way these words are not. Whoever she was teaching to talk, snow, she said, snow. And you opened your small brown fist and closed it and opened again to hold the reflection of torches and faces inside the window glass and through it, a cold black sheen of shapes and fires shaking. Kitchen lights, flakes that crisped and crossed other lights in lush diagonals, the snow-charmed traffic surging and pausing, red, green, white, the motion of motes and torches that at her word you reached out for where you were. It was you, that bright confusion.